Hi, this is Gary with MACMOST.com. Let me show you how you can create custom video travel maps using Apple Motion. MACMOST is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 1,000 supporters. Go to MACMOST.com/Patreon. There you could read more about it, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. Now recently I did a video on using the travel maps that are built into iMovie. But a lot of people wanted to know how to create custom travel maps using any map background they want, tracing a specific route along a road or trail, and maybe even using graphics inside like a little car icon or something. You can do that using Apple Motion. So Motion is an app from Apple. You get it in the App Store. It costs $50. And it's basically Apple's answer to Adobe After Effects. And you can do tons of different video animations using it. This is definitely going to be more complex than doing it in iMovie, but you can get just about any result that you want. So let's create a new Motion project. The idea here is that we're just going to export this as a video to use it somewhere else. And in this Motion project, the first thing I'm going to do is add the map. So I've got a map graphic already. I'm just going to add it here to the layers. And now it appears here in the timeline, just a map, doesn't do anything. The next thing I want to do now is draw a line that follows a trail. So I can zoom in here quite a bit and move around and I could find a spot, say, where I want to begin. So let's say I want to start like right here. And I can draw using a variety of different tools. They'll all work for this. I can use the drawing tool right here and actually draw on, which is hard when it's zoomed in like this. But I can also use the Bezier tool or the B-spline tool. I'll use the Bezier tool. It's just going to allow me to create a series of points. I click for a point, click for another point, and I can make it as detailed or as vague as I want. And I'm just going to go and continue just to draw on the different points to follow the trail. And now when I'm done, I'm going to double click on this last one and we'll finish it. And now you can see here, if I zoom back out, it creates a shape and it fills it in, which isn't what we want, of course. So I'm going to go to the inspector here on the left with the shape selected and turn fill off. So now we just have a line. And I can set the color for this line here under brush color. Let's pick something like a bright red, like that. And I could also set the width so I can make it, you know, really thick, or let's make it nice and thin here, like 2 point, like that. And now when I click to deselect that layer, you can see my line there. And it's just a line that's another layer here, just like the map. So all I've done is just draw on a line. I'm going to further customize it by selecting it here. And if I click, I can click one of these points. And notice if I control click it, I can smooth out that point. What I want to do before I do that is just with one point selected, do Command A to select all. And then I'm going to control click and smooth. So now all the points are smoothed out. So instead of these little hard corners every time I put a dot, now it's going to be nice and smooth. So that's what I've got right now. I've got a nice smooth curve that more or less follows that trail. To animate it so it draws on, I'm going to use a behavior. I'm going to select the Bezier curve here and I'm going to go to behaviors, and under shape there's write on, which is, you know, basically draw on. Draw it on over the course of its appearance on the timeline. So I do that, and now I scrub here, you can see how it draws the whole thing like that. And I can go to inspector here with the behavior selected. So I can see here this is the write on behavior. And I can do some things like, for instance, I can have the speed go from constant to ease in or ease out or ease, you know, both. So it accelerates in, has a constant speed, and then decelerates at the end. I can have it accelerate or decelerate throughout the entire thing. You can play with these. I'll just keep it at a constant speed here. So it draws it all on, and at this point I could be done. I could just export this. But you can see how I can highly customize this now. I can make the line there. I can make it a different color. I can make it a different width, for instance. And there are other properties I can play with as well, including the brush type even. And the behavior, I can change that as well in several different ways. So there's a lot you can do in addition to having your own custom map and everything. But let's say you want to have an icon, like, you know, if this was a map of the world, like a little airplane, or in this case, maybe a little hiker. So let's go and bring in a hiker graphic that I've prepared, and I will drop it in here at the top because I want it to appear above the map. And I'm going to shrink it a bit. This is huge. So in the inspector for the hiker here, I'll go to properties, and I'm going to scale it down quite a bit and make it something smaller like that. So now notice the hiker here, of course, started wherever I had the timeline. This is a constant pain in motion. It's always putting it there. I need to drag it over and have it kind of match the beginning right there. So everything is going to basically take the same amount of time. The hiker will be right now just sitting there the entire time, the entire 5 seconds. Let's have the hiker actually follow the path now. So I'm going to select, I can select the hiker or the group that contains the hiker. They're the same right now. And I could set a behavior for that. And the behavior I could set for it is for basic motion. And then I could have it follow a motion path. And you can see how it puts a line there. That's the motion path. And I can move back and forth and I could see it's following that path. I don't want it to follow that line path. I want it to follow the curve. The way I could do that is under a motion path right here, I could go and say, what is the path shape? Not an open spline, but follow a specific geometry. And then it creates this little drag and drop box. And I could drag the Bezier curve into that. And now the hiker will follow that curve. And there you go. There's the hiker at the top. And the hiker just follows along like that. If I deselect everything so you don't see the motion path, notice that the hiker is being drawn at the location where the line is currently at. So they match each other. Of course, that's because the motion path here is following the same speed constant, in this case, as the right on behavior constant. So you want to make sure that those match, else one will maybe get ahead of the other and all of that. Now, one last thing you may want to do is actually have the hiker point in the right direction. So the hiker always seems to be moving forward. A better graphic may, for instance, be this kayak here. I'm going to add that to this group here. So the kayak appears right there. And I'm going to go to the inspector properties. Let's scale the kayak down and let's get rid of the hiker. And now the kayak is there. Now, if I wanted it to point in the right direction, I would add to the group here, in addition to the motion path, I also want to add the basic motion of snap alignment to motion. Now, and once again here, you can see I need to move the kayak back to the beginning there and snap alignment to motion both there. It always is better if you kind of add new things when you've got the timeline at the very beginning. But now you can see that the kayak, if I deselect it, the kayak's always going to kind of orient itself at the trail, but unfortunately that's giving us a sideways kayak. So what we could do here in motion path is we can change the axis to vertical. There we go. So now it's pointing forward every time. So you can see the kayak follows the path, and that could be a car on a road or a plane in the sky, that kind of thing. You get the nice animation of it moving along. And if you want to use this in another project, you just go to File and then Share and then Export This as a Movie. I've got settings and I can change settings. Notice the resolution is 1920 by 1080. That's what this project was created in. If I go to Edit, Project Properties, that's where I could actually change the preset, say to 4K, for instance, if I needed that. Probably would have done that at the very beginning. But you can go to Share, Export. Let's just export this using the default settings and then open up a QuickTime player, and you can see it play out here. And I've got this video that I can now just import and use in any way I want and in some other app. And there's tons of other stuff that you can do in Motion. It's a huge app. I've shown you a tiny sliver of what it's capable of. So it's a lot of fun to play with if you like creating video, creating animation, and you like experimenting and exploring. Hope you found this useful. Thanks for watching. If you liked this video, click the thumbs up button below to let me know. I publish new tutorials each weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out.